in the following feature tag team event. It is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Blackpool, England, weighing 18 stone, 2 pounds, Lord Stephen Regal. His tag team partner, weighing 17 stone, 1 pound, Earl Robert Eaton.
For the first time ever, the Blue Bloods are out together in the ring. We go back to Gary.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents in this feature event. Total combined weight, 457 pounds. First, from Marietta, Georgia, Brad Armstrong. And from Morristown, Tennessee, Tim Turner.
You know, I really think, Brain, that even though he is now Earl Robert Eaton, that he is more like Jim Horner and Brad Armstrong than he is Lord Stephen Regal.
Well, you may think that way, but the knowledge that this man, his lordship there, Stephen Regal, has drummed into this man and worked on him and explained to him the proper way to live in society, I believe he sees a new light. He sees a direction. He'll listen to Lord Stephen Regal, not these two hicks.
It's the World Championship Wrestling version of My Fair Lady, I guess.
What do you say? He betrayed the United States of America?
To Bobby, yes.
Yeah. That's how you feel? People are going to start calling him a traitor and everything. I don't see it that way. He bettered himself.
I don't think there's any question. If he and Regal can mold as a team, they are going to be quite a force in the tag team wars. As a matter of fact, maybe one of the most dominant
referee,
forces.
We are nobility.
Well, this...
We do not drop our gowns on the floor. We need somebody to hold up
their gowns. I would think so, yes. They don't want their beautiful gowns to be soiled.
I'm sure someone will come and pick it up.
I'm telling you, you have to take it up. I'm going to start this match. I'm going to start the match.
Patrick needs to run things here, and that's what he's doing.
We need a hustler, brother.
A man's man.
Who's a man's man?
Well, they need a butler
here,
or a gentleman's gentleman.
Or a valet.
What a great job for Oakland.
Come here.
They've sent out Jimmy Jack.
Now, what's the feather costume?
Austria. Look, he was checking his hands to see if they were dirty.
My goodness. This is an event in itself, the disrobing of the Blue Bloods.
But see, they struck a deal. I know that. What Regal gave Bobby Eaton was class, manners, and dignity. What Bobby Eaton has been against Steve Regal is the most knowledge of anyone when it comes to tag team wrestling. They're going to be a perfect team.
All right, here we go. Finally. Be interesting to see. Bobby has changed as far as his manners and his...
He's improved himself.
Well, I just see what he does in the ring. Regal will start things. Regal and Tim Horner. First match for Lord Stephen and Earl Roberts. And a rip to the ears that time, maybe?
I wouldn't put it past him. And again, that's a good move.
We're crying out loud. Would they get in the ring and wrestle or what?
They're in the ring.
Into a full arm dragon twist. No denying Regal's scientific ability. The full arm dragon twist. A duck under. Regal, of course, Liverpool. There's certainly a resort city in England.
Is anything like the Tower of Terror next door?
No. And the home of one of the legendary wrestlers in all of the world, the famous Jack Pye.
Jack Pye.
P-Y-E.
You're back taking a shower. You keep messing with the Blue Bloods like this.
All right, now Earl Roberts for the very first time into the ring. We look forward to seeing this. This man is quite a competitor, but the competitor we remember is Beautiful Bobby.
Got a hand behind the back.
We don't remember this.
This is a new man. This is a new tag team. They may be new tag team champions before long. With Bobby Eaton on a team, knowing what he knows and what Regal knows, I mean... Harlem Heat, look out.
Sorry, it's not Bob Heat, it's Earl Roberts. Get it right.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
Midsection double snapmare. Brad Armstrong, Tim Hunter with a double elbow. No question about it, Horner and Armstrong have come to wrestle.
And they have no respect for the Earl, do they?
No, and they... I guess when you're knighted by the Queen of England, you have a special place in society, don't you?
Well, I mean, you know, he's the Earl of Eaton.
Yes, he is.
Has a nice ring to it.
The Earl of Eaton.
That'll get your reservation any place real quick.
Fred Armstrong, very tentative. And Earl Robert, very irate.
If I do this, then Armstrong's a pretty strong kid.
Yes, he is. But he's going for it, and the Greco-Roman knuckle lock.
But he's not a bright kid. And he's not a tall kid anymore.
No, not now he's not. Bobby with the leverage advantage here, standing as, of course, Brad down on the mat. He's going to take all the reserve that Brad has to try to combat this, and look what happened.
The Earl of Eaton even has different facial expressions now. This is a whole different man.
And he makes a pretty darn good ladder, too. Up on top, Brad. Down on Lord Steven Regal. Here comes Tim Horner. A bench press. We've got a four-way brawl.
He just walked up a man.
Yes, yes, he did. Up and down, my buddy drop. Tim Horner.
It's time, gentlemen, to regroup. Get your strategy down, and don't let these redneck hicks push you around. You're better than them, and you know it.
I don't know if they are better than them. Are you think better human beings? Is that what you're saying?
Well, there is such a thing as better human beings.
There is?
Oh, yes. Gordon always says he's better than you. You told me that on 5-6 different occasions.
I don't believe that. You've been saying that since you and I have been together, and I do not believe...
Gordon hates you.
Are you serious?
Gordon solely hates you.
Gordon's always been a gentleman around me.
He's setting you up. That's his business. I don't want to get
you are a troublemaker. You are an instigator. Knee. Lord Steven Regal back in the ring now. And Brad Armstrong powering up again. Boy, the youngster just will not give up.
Got a lot of fight in him.
And a lot of ability. To the midsection, flips him over, holding the hands. Regal to the top, and Brad catches it.
Like the inside of a cheap watch. I don't see so many moving parts.
Brad caught in the wrong corner, and Bobby laying him in. A warning from Nick Patrick.
That was a great move by Brad Armstrong.
It really was. But he ended up in the Blue Bloods corner, which is no man's land, and that's why Bobby and Regal had the advantage. I'm sorry, Earl Roberts and Lord Stephen had the advantage then.
See, that's what I mean. He may have a lot of ability, but he's not a real bright guy. He's a hick.
Who, Bobby?
No, Armstrong.
Oh. Well, I guess you can't call Bobby a hick.
The Earl of Eaton?
The
of
Earl
course of... not. He won't like it. He knows which knife and fork to use now. He knows what side the spoon goes on, where the napkin goes.
You notice how they tag in and out? They just kind of brush hands instead of a firm, hard tag. I guess no wasted movement, huh?
No wasted energy. Save that for the Hammond Eggers.
Brad caught in the corner again, and the blue blood double team brought Armstrong.
And it's also an act of courtesy. I'll tell you this, Bobby knows everything there is about tag team wrestling. He's got the prime minister of the team there talking to the referee, and he's taking over.
Front face lock. The full arm dragon twist. Knee to the gut. Uppercut.
He's not letting him get to his corner.
Forearm shot, snapmare takeover, and a tag. Stomp on the head.
Take him out.
No weird. Bobby ducks his head. Forearm shot, suplex. And now, who can make the tag?
The Earl will. The Earl's closer to his corner.
You're right, he is. Brad makes it. Tim Horner. He's hit anything that moves. Picks up Bobby. Ducks and picks up Regal. Armstrong and Horner now in control of the match.
Come on, referee, do something.
Well, he's trying to here, Brain.
He's caught in the middle. He doesn't know where to go. He don't want to get hurt.
Now he's sending, okay. He got Bobby in his corner, he's sending Brad out. Uh-oh. A last cheap shot in the back.
Not a cheap shot, but tag team wrestling.
The Regal stretch, and Brad stops that.
Uh-oh.
Bobby up on top.
I'm going to rename this move.
You are?
What it used to be called.
The Alabama Jam.
I'm now calling it the Tower of London.
Well, I guess so, because it beheads the opponent. The Tower of London.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Lord Stephen Regal and Earl Robert Eaton, the Blue Bloods.
And Regal wants to get back in there again, but the Blue Bloods secure a very tough win in their opening bout here on WCW Worldwide since their union.
Very impressive. Extremely impressive.
More still to come from Disney MGM.